The heart is deceitful. Life is a battle. I said that. Life is a battle. Life is a fight. A battle against the wickedness of men. It might not be a wish flying in the air. It might be a man sitting by you. It might be a woman sitting by you. It might be a child sitting by you. Assigned to cripple you. My father said several times that he had people who came to his house to come and cook. Unknown to him for 2 years, they were killing him. Daddy Enoch Adeboye, is he Adeboye, the Gio? He had a servant in his house, I think that was for 13 years, putting poison in his food, he never knew. Look at that caliber of a man that all of us are looking up to. He never knew, he could not see. Life is a battle. Life is a fight. A battle against the wickedness of men. My father had a secretary in his office. He never knew she was employed by witches to come and terminate his life. For more than 2 years, the girl was doing all sorts of things. But one day God revealed, and then the girl began to manifest. The girl said, I'm not saying again, I'm going. Wickedness for 2 years. I don't know what she may have done for 2 years. I don't know what she may have crippled. I don't know what businesses she may have stopped in the realm of the spirit. Because she was loved personified. Everything she said was love. Everything she said was nice. So my father was like, what kind of girl is this? I love this girl. Say, oh, I like this girl. Let people not get me wrong. Not knowing that she was a witch sent to come and kill. Life is a battle. Life is a fight. A battle against the wickedness of men. Jeremiah 17, 9, 10. Some of you say we are killing demons. Jeremiah 17, 9, 10. The heart is deceitful above all things and beyond cure. Who can understand it? I, the Lord, search the heart and examine the mind, you see, to reward each person according to their conduct, according to what their deeds deserve. So what does that mean? To survive in this wicked generation, you must deal with the wickedness of the heart of men. I'll give you a testimony here. So many times, a woman wanted to get married. Seven marriages failed. Why? Because she had a bridesmaid who was from the kingdom of hell, who was from the marine kingdom, who was driving away the men. Every day was time to go to the altar. That bridesmaid will manipulate things and that man will run away. Seven. Why? Because of a friend. Choose your friends rightly. Many of you, I don't know what is happening. I don't know that kind of manipulation. That you call people who cannot solve your problem, neither spiritually, neither financially, and you are explaining your problems to them. Error! You are manipulated. That manipulation catches fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Why would I take my problem to someone who cannot solve it? Why would I explain my problems to someone who cannot solve it? That is why God regretted in Genesis 6:6 that he created a man because of the wickedness of the heart of men. We live in such a wicked generation where people are not happy to see you, their own fellow brethren in pain. A wicked generation that when you tell a brother, when you tell a sister who does not love you from the heart, that, oh, you just had a testimony, they'll tell you, I'm rushing to war. But as soon as you tell them that you lost money, they'll sit down, they'll balance, they'll take a seat, and they'll buy a drink so that you can drink and be hearing the story. Wicked generation. Not that they'll pray for you. We live in such a wicked generation. And something happened here recently, and I heard some things, and I began to ask God why this will happen. And God began to teach me it is a sign of the end time. That we live in a generation where many regret being related to certain relatives because of the wickedness of the heart. A brother is killing a brother. A sister is killing. He's killing you and he's smiling with you. He's selling your land and he's smiling with you. He's telling you to come and take something that he has poisoned it. You need discernment. You need to be a warrior to be able to discern what the enemy has planned. We have such a case here where a man who brought a girl from Cameroon. Me and my wife were privileged to go and solve this problem. About 60 years old. That guy, before he left here, sir, to go and bring that, he could not sleep. That's about 10 years ago. He could not sleep. 60 years old. The wife was 30, 40 years old. Before he left here to go and bring, because he came here to study and the family was in Cameroon. He borrowed money everywhere, including from me. Went to Cameroon, took that girl, brought her here. My wife is here. Guess what? She came here and she started dating. Oh my God. She was even pregnant before she got here. The wickedness of men. And it's not just a woman that does that in this generation. Even a man does that. She was pregnant before she came here. Many are in marriages today, but literally they regret the kind of wife, the kind of husband they married. And God showed me that the fact that Cain and Abel could kill, Cain could kill Abel is an indication that a brother can kill a brother, that a brother can kill a sister. You must be careful. The fact that Jacob took his brother's blessing deceptively tells us that even a biological brother can be deceptive. I know of a guy who came to me and was speaking, oh, I want to go and take my properties. Someone is holding them for me. I want to go. I said, don't go. Another person came and said, that land, forget that land. Because you go there, you die. What is a land as compared to your life? Because someone you trusted so much stood on that land. And he said, if you cross, you die. But that's someone you left the land in his hand to look after the land. Wickedness. So you must be on fire at all times to get the signals. That Joseph's brother sold him as a slave is an indication, child of God, that even those with the same name as you can sell you for money. That Laban cheated Jacob many times is an indication, child of God, that you can have a wicked in-law. And the Lord said to me, son, why are you surprised? Judas killed Jesus is an indication that your best friend can be your enemy in disguise. Look how easily they took Samson's wife and gave it to his best man. Samson, you know, they took his wife and gave it to his best man. They took his own wife. So the best man came with him. They went to the wedding. After the wedding, Samson left, went back to his father. The best man turned around and married the wife. In fact, the parents gave the wife to the best man. I decree and I declare, any man, any woman, any boy, any girl, any child, year or far, that is a sacred enemy smiling with you, but is happy that you failed. Let the fire of the Holy Ghost expose them in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let the fire of the Holy Ghost expose them in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let Jehovah show you a sign in the name of Jesus. Amen. I say, if I be a man of God, the oil on my head will start exposing and fighting your enemies in the name of Jesus. Amen. I declare, whosoever they are, as God arises today, they will go down by fire, by thunder, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you, my Father.